Today, we are putting the spotlight on the Problems App. The Problems App is the place for DevOps, IT Ops, site reliability engineers, platform engineers, for everybody really that is responsible for a piece of infrastructure or for critical applications to understand if there are any problems, if they're responsible for the problems, and how to fix these problems. So I just open up the app here. I'm on the playground tenant. So remember, you can do everything that I just do as well, because you can open up your playground tenant or try the same thing on your own Dynatrace environment. A couple of things I want to explain before I dive into some of the details of individual problems that Davis AI identified for me. With like most of our apps in Dynatrace, you have some filter options. You can filter on segments, right? So filter down on particular types of data on a particular environments. You can filter on your time frame. Like with any other apps, you can focus on a particular time frame you're interested in. Now, on the left side, you also have some quick filters on categories. When I talk with site reliability engineers, they're often worried about availability, errors, and slowdowns. So you can immediately filter, and as you can see, as you are clicking and checking these boxes, it's just really the filter bar that is updated, but you don't need to type anything. Now, one thing that immediately kind of gets my attention, if I look at the problems that are currently found, there's a lot of not all pods ready. So what I can do if I want to get a quick overview, I don't want to go into every problem and look at the details, but let's just select maybe the first three. And you can see here, you can say now explain with AI. So that is pretty cool. So I can use Davis to explain to me what are these three problems without having to go into each problem. And also, are there any similarities? Is there any relationship between the problems, right? And it seems they're all running into the same environment. They all belong to the same open telemetry demo app. So that's already a really cool, interesting productivity boost, because I don't need to open up every problem detail and do my analysis. Davis AI is doing it for me. We'll come back to Davis AI in a second. Now, I have availability, error, and slowdown. That's great. But on a Davis problem, on a Davis detector problem, you can see here we have name, status, category, root cause, started duration, and here many other fields. We actually have quite a lot of fields that you can add to the table. Most of them are by default there because we are propagating this metadata to your problem. But in the settings, you can also specify your own metadata that you have on your Kubernetes deployments, that you have on your events, to be upgraded and kind of migrated to the problem itself. So for instance, right, I can now go here and I can scroll down here, and for instance, I have host name, cluster name, Kubernetes namespace. Could also be a product, cost center. I see a lot of people and organizations have ownership information on your deployments, and so you can also propagate it and then filter for it or search for it. I'm going to choose namespace, and I'm going to focus on, let's see, the AstroShop. AstroShop is one of the open telemetry demo apps that we host here on the playground. So with a single click, I now get to see all the problems that Dynatrace has detected on the AstroShop namespace for availability, error, or slowdown. Before I jump into the details, two things. If this is a filter that I'm interested in, I can set it to the default filter, and I can also click on the little bell here. The bell enables me to turn on notifications, so I get notified in case new problems come in that match my filter criteria. So that's pretty cool. Now, JavaScript error rate increase. Guess what? I don't need to click on it if I want to get a quick explanation. I can just say explain with the AI. And so now Davis is explaining to me what is this problem really all about. It seems there's a Java error rate increase. The error rate is now 5.53%. If I scroll up, it's so fast. It tells me there's multiple endpoints, the API checkout and charge. What has happened, the payment service seems to have reached 100% failure rate, so it really gives me great insights into what has actually happened. It also tells me what I can do. I can investigate the root cause. I can analyze logs and traces. I can do error analysis. So Davis really helps me here in case I need to understand what is the root cause, what is the impact, and what are potential remediation steps. Now, let's open up the details, though, of this problem to just dive a little bit more deeper into what the app can provide. So for those of you that already know the app, a couple of quick things that for those of you that are new. So deployment, that basically tells me where are my root cause components. In this case, the AstroShop payment service has been marked as root cause. And I also see in the deployment where it is deployed, on which workload, on which namespace, in which cluster. That's great. On the right side, right? Because now I have the root cause component by default selected, kind of follow the red, we automatically highlight the problematic areas. It shows me that the service failure rate has increased of the AstroShop payment service. And it was always at zero, and then all of a sudden it jumped to 100%. So that's great. Now, clearly what I want to do, I want to analyze the failures. But I also want to show you that we have direct links now to say, just analyze that service, show me the failed traces, show me the related logs, or open up this particular entity, the service, with any other app in Dynatrace. But clearly, I think for me, analyze failures makes the most sense. So we also have a new feature now in the services app that is opened here directly, doing failure analysis. It opens up that service for the failed requests for that time frame of the problem, and it compares it to a previous time frame. And this seems to be 7 days ahead. Now, in our case, we have the playground tenant. We're always simulating the same problems at the same time. So this is why the problem actually really happens at the same time. But you get the idea, you will see a difference in different time frames. Now, what I like, you also see the related logs, and you also see the endpoint. Remember, it was the charge endpoint that we've been Davis told us about earlier, that's a problem. It's also listed here, and with one click, I can also look at the traces. Now, I will record a second video on the services app where we go deeper into what's new here. Let's focus on the problems app now. Let me go back to the problems. So on the problem itself, I highlighted here the analyze failures, the additional links. And this is true not only for the root cause, but this is true for any type of event that you have here, right? We always give you the options to click on the next thing. Also really cool, troubleshooting. Now, most of the time, in my experience, many times, a problem does not only happen once. It's possible that a problem that you fix today may happen again next week, or maybe in a month, or maybe in a year. But at that point, maybe it's a different team that is on call, and they would really benefit if they would already see everything that you have done the first time around when you fix the problem. So now on the troubleshooting tab, we are highlighting all of the notebooks and dashboards on your Dynatrace environment that contain information that looks similar to this problem. So we are actually indexing all the documents. And if a new problem happens, like JavaScript error rate increase on this particular environment, then we highlight if there are already existing notebooks or dashboards that have been used in the past. And it seems there was one already. I can click on view notebook and I get to see a notebook that I've created for an earlier problem, and it gives me already some guidance. Now the cool thing is, if I go back to my problem, for instance, if you have not created any notebook yet, or the notebook is, you know, for whatever reason not helpful, you can obviously create a new notebook or a dashboard right from here. Click on new and it will create a new notebook. I click on view notebook, and you can see here it's really with a default structure, so you don't have to go, you don't have to start from scratch. We already highlight and put in the certain things that we want you to include in that notebook that will make your troubleshooting, your incident response, your postmortem easier. And later on, Davis will also index it. But remember, there's also a tip on the top, remember to share this document so that Davis Copilot can suggest it to the rest of your team. So once you're done with it, make sure you share it. Right, let's go back to the problem, the problems app. On the top, as we always had it, high level information about the impacted services, impacted users. That's all great. We talked about the troubleshooting. We also should talk about logs. I mean, logs have been here for a while, but I know that maybe not everybody knows this already. We also automatically show you which logs happened in the impacted services that are part of this problem. And what I really like about it, I'm not a big log expert, right? I don't know what are the best logs to look for, but I always hear get recommended queries. So Dynatrace tells me show the last 100 warning logs, run the query, and then you don't have to be an expert in DQL. You just get the queries and you automatically get all the logs with all the details, right? So this is pretty cool. Let me close this. As we said earlier, you can always ask Davis for help. So explain with the AI, whether you're in the table view, whether you're in here, you always have an expert at hand. And this is our Davis AI, right? Explaining to you what the problem is and what you should do next, right? Analyze the root cause, analyze service failures. And we have already done all of this. So I hope you will see that the Problems app is truly here to help you. The Problems app is obviously just a visualization of the real work that happens behind the scenes in our Davis AI, because we are doing causal AI, we are doing predictive AI, and we're doing generative AI. And with all of these, we really identify problems, we categorize it, we show you the root cause, and then we make it easy for you because we explain what the problem is and we give you the right next steps. All right, this is the App Spotlight for the Problems app. Check out some of our other App Spotlights. Bye.